nine humans who were raised by wild animals. Stories of children raised by animals have long existed in media, myths, and folklore. Children like Mowgli or Tarzan were raised by wild animals in the jungle, while Remus and Romulus suckled on the milk of wild wolves. There are myths in the Amazon of people who change into jaguars, and in the Arctic there is a myth of a woman who marries a brown bear. The idea of an impenetrable barrier between humans and animals seems to come from the monotheistic tradition, and historically seems to be in the minority of beliefs worldwide. But today, it seems that the accepted belief is that in some way, humans and other animals are fundamentally different. Even as evolutionary biologists attack the belief of human exceptionalism, we continue to act as if we are superior to all other life forms. The idea of children growing up without humans, more influenced by other animals than their own species, seems initially hard to believe. As wild as it may seem, beneath the fiction of myth and legend is a hard seed of reality. Children left without human companionship at an early age are left growing up without language or basic knowledge of human society. These children are known as feral, wild, or properly referred to as isolates, and there are several historical examples. Number 9. Peter the Wild Boy, Germany. A naked, hairy boy walking on all fours emerged from the woods near Hamelin, Germany in 1724. Eventually coaxed into being captured, he behaved like a wild animal, choosing to eat both birds and vegetables raw, and was incapable of speaking. After being moved to England, he was given the name of Peter the Wild Boy. Though he never learned to talk, he supposedly loved music, was taught menial tasks, and lived to an advanced age. A gravestone marks where he was laid to rest in a churchyard in 1785. Number 8. Lobo Wolf Girl, Mexico. In 1845, a mysterious girl was seen running on all fours in the company of wolves attacking a herd of goats near San Felipe, Mexico. The story was corroborated a year later when the girl was seen again, this time devouring a freshly killed goat. As the story goes, alarmed local villagers mounted a search for the girl days later, eventually capturing her. Supposedly, she howled incessantly throughout the night, attracting a pack of wolves that charged into the village in an apparent rescue attempt. She was able to sneak out of her enclosure and escape. The girl was not seen again until 1852, when she was reportedly witnessed suckling two wolf cubs on a sandbar in a river. After being seen, she gathered up the two cubs, ran back into the woods, and was never heard from again. Number 7. Saturday Mithyane, South Africa. A boy of around 5 was found after spending about a year in the company of monkeys in KwaZulu-Natal, South Africa, in 1987. In 2005, at the age of 17, he was still behaving like a monkey. He didn't talk at all, walked like a monkey, refused to eat cooked food, and never played with other children, though he still exhibited affection towards monkeys. Number 6. Marcos Rodriguez Pantoja, Spain. Marcos Rodriguez Pantoja is a famous case of a man who is said to have been raised by wolves. In his early childhood, Marcos was sold as a slave by his father to a man to tend his goat herd. Marcos was then brought to a small cave where a goat herder lived, watching the flock. When the goat herder died, Marcos retreated into the Sierra Morena mountains of northern Spain, where he trapped rabbits for food as the goat herder had taught him. Marcos watched other animals to learn what was edible and what wasn't. On one rainy night, the young boy sought shelter in a cave where he slept with wolf pups. The first encounter with an adult wolf was perilous, but Marcos claims he was befriended and sometimes given food. Eventually, police caught Marcos in his teens and forcibly dragged him into civilization. Even into his 70s, Marcos seemed to have a hard time relating to other humans. Number 5. Lyoka, Moscow. In December 2007, Russian authorities brought in a boy who was living with wolves. He looked to be around 10, but may have actually been much older. He didn't appear to speak any Russian and exhibited wolf-like behavior. Some villagers found him in a lair made from leaves in freezing temperatures fairly close to Moscow. The authorities brought him in, gave him a shower, and cut his nails, and he escaped from the facility in 24 hours. Nothing is known of his whereabouts. Number 4. Sidi Muhammad, North Africa. Sidi Muhammad, the ostrich boy, told his amazing story in 1945. At the age of 5 or 6, he wandered off from his North African family, found an ostrich net with chicks hatching, and befriended the parent ostriches. They took care of him, teaching him to run fast and sheltering him by each extending a wing over him. At the age of 12, he was taken back to his parents by mounted ostrich hunters. He later married and had children. During his time with the ostriches, he was mostly eating grass. Number 3. Anonymous boy, Russia. An anonymous 7-year-old Russian boy wasn't exactly abandoned by his mother, a 31-year-old Russian woman, but his life may have gone a little smoother had he been. Before he was discovered in 2008, the young man had been raised entirely as a bird. According to Russian newspaper Pravda, the boy's mother was infatuated with birds. She had a large collection of domestic birds and regularly fed wild birds as well. As her son grew, she refused to speak to him or let him out of the apartment. Instead, she treated him just like one of her birds. As a result, when he was found by authorities at age 7, he was only able to communicate in bird chirps. The boy was taken from his mother's care and sent to live in a psychological care facility. Number 2. John Sebunya, Uganda. In the mid-1980s, as Uganda was in the throes of a violent civil war, young John Sebunya was a mere toddler of 2. One night, in a fit of rage, John's father killed his mother, prompting the terrified child to flee into the jungle. There he stayed for the next year, surviving only thanks to the benevolence of a group of monkeys. A few days into his feral life, Sebunya was approached by a small family of monkeys who offered him roots, nuts, sweet potatoes, and cassava. Sebunya also learned his behavior from the monkeys. For example, as a boy, he'd rarely meet people's eyes. Fortunately, though, John survived and was raised by a new family. And though he's happy where he is, John explains that he feels fortunate to have been found by the group of monkeys who would become his short-lived family. "I am grateful. Yes, I am," he says. "Because, not because of love from them, from the monkeys, but because what they did made it possible for me to be loved by other people, by humans." Number 1. Marina Chapman, Colombia. Marina was kidnapped, probably for ransom, but then was abandoned in the Colombian jungle. She was lucky enough to be adopted by a group of capuchin monkeys, which are known to accept human children in their groups. The animals taught young Marina how to catch birds and rabbits with her bare hands, so she was able to survive and take care of herself. After 5 years, she was rescued by hunters, who found her and sold her to a brothel. At that point, she had no human language capabilities. She ran away from the brothel, lived on the streets, and became a slave to a mafia family. Through some connection she made and some sheer luck, she managed to get to Bradford as a nanny, where she met her future husband and established a family. The story is so amazing that many scientists doubted it. However, Carlos Conde, a professor in Colombia, stated that he did a test using Chapman's reactions to photos of her adopted family and photos of capuchin monkeys that proved that Chapman was telling the truth.